So in the final video of this series, we're going to look at processing a service order and posting based on the site visit from the service technician. So again, here we are in Business Central. I'm going to show you how you can enter and post the consumption of any inventory or any labor within Business Central application. But lots of people have automated this to be able to do it on a power app so that you can do it on a mobile device, or used a really great ISP called ExpandIT, which is really geared towards a service technician who is out in the field. But for now, I will just focus on service orders within BC. So the service technician has come back and they've indicated the time and the inventory needed. So I can go into my service order. I would then find the service order that was for that service call. And I can go ahead under the service lines, and they would be able to validate the time that was spent. So let's say, as an example, they ended up needing a few extra screws, maybe a little bit of extra time was needed. They could even indicate that they needed a part that they didn't initially think that they needed. So they can go ahead and you would be able to add whatever the new item is that they needed. So let's say that they needed to do a little bit of spray paint. They needed to, you know, fix up where they had done the new screws and make it look fresh and new again. So in this case, what I've got is I'm then indicating in my quantity to ship and quantity to consume, I can post what actually happened. Before I do that, the tech can even add notes about the service call and what went on. So similar to what you can do in other areas, you can add a description field and just leave your type blank to add comments. So again, I can say for that item, or needed, whatever. I can keep going, I can add more notes, and then of course that can also be something that presents on the document. So what I can do now is I can select whatever lines I want to decrease or consume. So I can go ahead, I can indicate to post, and then I could go ahead, I can ship an invoice, I can ship and consume my labor. Lots of different options here, but for now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to ship. And now I can see here, I've got everything that's been shipped, and similar to, you know, a sales order, purchase order, you have to ship it before you can invoice it. But now at that point, I would have decreased the on hand for any of the items that I had. And then down the line, what I would do is I could go ahead and I could post, and then we can invoice for this as well. Again, what's similar to other areas is the service order has completely changed when I shipped and invoiced it. And I will then have a posted service shipment that I could create and, you know, maybe send to my customer based on the visit. I can go ahead and, you know, I can show internal information. If there's lot serial information, I'm going to go ahead and just show us the out of the box form. So here I'm able to basically do, as I mentioned, like a packing slip or some kind of confirmation of the work that was actually completed. So I have the service item, the serial number that I went out and worked on. I will let the customer know how much time was spent, what the quantity is, again, any inventory that I may have used. Similarly, I can go ahead and go to my posted service invoice. And same thing, I can then print or send anything to somebody who needs to then pay for that service. So again, I show my company address. So the documents will all look very similar, but of course they all serve their different purposes. You've got your order acknowledgement to acknowledge the work and the time that we estimate that we're going to need. You've got your service shipment, which is more of a confirmation of the work that was actually done. maybe give the customer an opportunity to dispute anything or just confirm back that that all looks okay. And then you've got your posted service invoice so that if there is a balance or something that the customer needs to pay, you can go out and send that. And again, very similar where I'm able to then just see for that specific service order what I'm billing them for. If there's any questions or concerns about the service modules, the things that it can do, looking at how you would be able to track service repairs, status them, potentially look at fault reason codes, be able to enter the service quotes and service orders, and then post the service work once the technician is done, or even questions on really awesome ISVs to help the service technicians on their mobile out in site, like ExpandIT, feel free to use the contact information provided.